Welcome to DWBI Adda channel. Please subscribe for latest training videos.
Hello, welcome back to another video tutorial on Seaborn. In our last session, we worked on categorical scatter plots. With the growing of the dataset, categorical scatter plots become limited to provide information about the distribution of values within the category. In such situation, we basically convert our focus to categorical distribution plots. And in this session, we will start working on different types of categorical distribution plots. We are going to start this session with the basic definition of categorical distribution. According to statistics, a categorical distribution is a discrete probability distribution which describes the possible result of a random variable that can work with one of the possible categories. It is basically the generalization of Bernoulli distribution for a categorical random variable. And one of the most important features of this distribution is they do not have any influence on variable ordering. We basically have three choices for this kind of plots, and they are box plot, Boxen plot, and violin plots. Their working principles are almost same, only the difference is in their figure style. Similar to our previous session, we will work with catplot, but we only consider box, boxen, and violin plot and their related parameters. This dodge parameter is used when we need to display the hue variable levels along with categorical axes. Whenever the hue variable contains two levels, we can use this. Setting split to true will draw half of the violin for each level. CART is used in violin plot. It is basically the bandwidth size to extend the density past the extreme data points. In scale, we use the method that will help to scale the width of the violin. Finally, the inner parameter. It will represent the data points in the violin interior. If we set box, it will draw a miniature box plot, and in case of quartiles, it will draw the quartiles of the distribution. Now we will go to Jupyter and continue there. Similar to our previous session, first we import Seaborn library. Now we load TIPS dataset into TIPS local variable. TIPS dataset contains a total of 6 variables, and of them, total bill, tips, and size are numeric variables and others are categorical variables. We will start categorical distribution plot from this box plot. We can easily draw a box plot setting box to this kind parameter. We set day categorical variable in X and total bill numeric variable in Y axis. Let's generate this plot. It has generated 4 different boxes for 4 different levels of day variable. This box plot shows the 3 quartile values of the distribution along with the extreme values. This line in the middle is the median value of the data set. This starting and finishing line of the box represents the first and third quartile of the data set. These whiskers extend to point that lie within 1.5 IQR of lower and upper quartile. And then observations that fall outside this range are displayed independently. This means each value in the box plot corresponds to an actual observation in the data. We can add third variable in hue semantics, and the box for each level of the hue variable is moved along the categorical axes so that they don't overlap. This behavior is called dodging, and we can manage this using this dodge parameter. If the categorical levels come separately, we can change these dodges to false. We are planning to create a new variable weekend and set true for only Sat and Sunday. So in weekend variable, we will have two levels, yes and no, but they won't come together. Let's execute our plan. So we have two levels in weekend, but they don't come together, so that we can easily disable the dodges. Now we work with box and plot, which is similar to a box plot but optimized for showing more information about the shape of the distribution. To generate a boxin plot, we have to set boxin to the kind parameter of catplot function. Let's execute this. So this is our boxin plot from the same day and total bill variables. Now we are going to focus on violin plot, which combines a box plot with the kernel density estimation. Let's generate a violin plot from the same day and total bill variables. Similar to box plot, it also shows minimum, maximum range and three quartiles. This white dot in the middle is the median. This thick black rectangle is the IQR range, and this black whisker is the maximum and minimum range. We can add third variable in hue, and similar to box plot, each level of hue variable will be moved along the categorical axis. Sex variable has two levels and they have displayed together in same axis level. If the hue variable contains exactly two levels, we can use this split parameter. If we set true, it splits violin to compare the levels for the hue variable. Let's execute this one. So this is the desired violin plot with splitted levels. As the violin plot uses a KDE, there are some other parameters that we may need to use, like a BW and cut parameter. We can set a specific BW and cut for our violin plot. As we set 0 to cut, it limits the violin range within the range of the observed data. If we generate a violin plot, the default scale of this violin is area and inner is a box, but we can change them based on our requirements. Suppose if we change the inner to quartile, the quartile will be displayed through a line. Let's execute this one. So the quartiles are represented by the line. Finally, we can combine scatter or swarm plots inside the distribution plots. Let's execute this. In this example, first we generated a violin plot and then we combined swarm plot on it. We are done with Jupyter. Let's return to the presentation. In this session, we have discussed about categorical distribution plots like box plot, boxen plot and violin plots with their associated parameters. That's all for today. See you in the next tutorials.